A lot has changed this year. For a significant portion of you, working from home has become living in the office. Formerly intimate spaces have taken on a professional function. So how can we stop this paradigm shift that's causing work to engulf and dominate our once sacred and peaceful homes? Well, truthfully, it'll never be the same. But there are some things we can do to try and limit work from home fatigue. Hi there. So for those of you that don't know me, my name is Killian, and today we're just going to be running through three quick tips on how you can separate work from home while working from home. So starting out with number one, the fake commute. So in Dublin, where I work, the average commute is actually just under an hour long. And this will generally involve some form of public transport like the Lewis or the bus and some walking to the final destination. Over time, we've become conditioned to use this as a break in the day, to switch on or switch off depending on whether you're heading in or heading out of work. Well then, why don't we just recreate this at home? As tempting as it is to peel yourself out of the bed at 8:55 in the morning, I would recommend that you get up half an hour to an hour early and go out and get some steps in. I know this is a bit difficult at the moment because the weather is not cooperating and it's still relatively dark in the morning, but the disconnect you can create in both the morning and the evening is well worth it. I find that in the morning, this really kickstarts my day, and in the evening, it allows me to approach whatever activities I'm gonna do with a fresh head. In number two, we're gonna look at some workspace habits that can be leveraged to also create this disconnect. Having a dedicated workspace allows you to have a physical endpoint where you stop working and start being present with others. Now, I know everyone doesn't have this privilege. I myself have only recently moved into a two-bed, and my girlfriend and I are using the master bedroom as an office, but this has been a game changer for me. Previously, I was just working at a kitchen table in a shared apartment, and I wasn't able to create half as much of a disconnect. While I was working there, and I couldn't create this disconnect, I had an alternative approach, which was still somewhat effective. This involved a specific routine of tidying. So taking everything from work, packing it into a rucksack if possible, and sliding it under a couch or a bed so that it was physically out of view. I would do this to indicate to my brain that work was over, and it actually worked fairly well. And you know, as the phrase goes, out of sight, out of mind. Similarly, what I've started doing recently is getting dressed up for work and then getting dressed down in the evening, again, just to make some sort of split in the day. So while these processes may seem almost trivial, the idea here is that we want to create a state of home and a state of work, and it will occur after a while. Finally, I want to talk about setting specific hours. I understand better than anyone that you won't just be able to log off when you want and unwind in the evenings. But to the best of your abilities, you should be trying to create a routine. Indicating to yourself that your work hours are between 9 and 6, or more likely something like 8 in the morning to 9 at night, but having those specific hours means that you can actually unwind outside of those hours, but you do have to be strict with them. Now, personally, I don't manage to keep to this, but when I did see a huge benefit from it. Now more than ever, we need to look out for our physical and mental well-being. Let's be honest, for a lot of people, it's been a shite year. No point sugarcoating it. And that's why you need to look out for you. Treat yourself like someone you care about and set boundaries between work and home life. So everyone, those are my tips. Thank you very, very much for watching this video. If you enjoyed the video, please give that like button a slap. If you really enjoyed it, share it with a friend. And if you want to see more videos like this one, hit the sub button below. See you in the next one. Good luck.